as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. We, the daughters and sons of him who built the valleys and plains, praise the wonders our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, we call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Draw near to your servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness, that for those who glory in you as their creator and guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. In the beginning of the reign of Zedekiah, king of Judah, in the fifth month of the fourth year, the prophet Hananiah, son of Azur from Gibeon, said to me in the house of the Lord, in the presence of the priests and all the people, "Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, I will break the yoke of the king of Babylon. Within 2 years, I will restore to this place all the vessels of the temple of the Lord, which Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, took away from this place to Babylon. And I will bring back to this place of Jeconiah, son of Jehoiakim, king of Judah, for all the exiles of Judah who went to Babylon, says the Lord. For I will break the yoke of the kingdom of Babylon." The prophet Jeremiah answered the prophet Hananiah, in the presence of the priests and all the people assembled in the house of the Lord, and said, "Amen, thus says the Lord, do. May he fulfill the things you have prophesied by bringing the vessels of the house of the Lord and all the exiles back from Babylon to this place. But now, listen to what I am about to state in your hearing and the hearing of all the people. From of old, the prophets who were before you and me prophesied war, woe, and pestilence against many lands and mighty kingdoms. But the prophet who prophesies peace is recognized as truly sent by the Lord only when his prophetic prediction is fulfilled." Thereupon the prophet Hananiah took the yoke, from the neck of the prophet Jeremiah and broke it, and said in the presence of all the people, "Thus says the Lord, even so within 2 years, I will break the yoke of Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, from off the neck of all the nations." At that, the prophet Jeremiah went away. Sometime after the prophet Hananiah had broken the yoke from off the neck of the prophet Jeremiah, the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah, "Go tell Hananiah this, thus says the Lord, by breaking a wooden yoke, you forge an iron yoke. For thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, a yoke of iron I will place on the necks of all these nations serving Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, and they shall serve him, even the beasts of the field I give him." To the prophet Hananiah, the prophet Jeremiah said, "Hear this, Hananiah, the Lord has not sent you, and you have raised false confidence in this people. For this says the Lord, I will dispatch you from the face of the earth. This very year you shall die, because you have preached rebellion against the Lord." That same year, in the 7th month, Hananiah the prophet died. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Remove from me the way of falsehood, and favor me with your law.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Take not the word of truth from any mouth, for in your ordinances is my hope.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Let those turn to me who fear you, and acknowledge your decrees.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Let my heart be perfect in your statutes, that I be not put to shame.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Sinners wait to destroy me, but I pray, heed to your decrees.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
From your ordinances I turn not away, for you have instructed me.
Lord, teach me your statutes. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus heard of the death of John the Baptist, he withdrew in a boat to a deserted place by himself. The crowds heard of this and followed him on foot from their towns. When he disembarked and saw the vast crowd, his heart was moved with pity for them, and he cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples approached him and said, "This is a deserted place, and it is already late. dismiss the crowds so that they can go to the villages and buy food for themselves. He said to them, "There is no need for them to go away. Give them some food yourselves." But they said to him, "Five loaves and two fish are all we have here." Then he said, "Bring them here to me." Then he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. Taking the five loaves and the two fish and looking up to heaven, he said the blessing, broke the loaves, and gave them to the disciples, who in turn gave them to the crowds. They all ate and were satisfied, and they picked up the fragments left over 12 wicker baskets full. Those who ate were about 5,000 men, not counting women and children. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
The story of the multiplication of the loaves and fish was a very important story for the early church. That is why the four evangelists really like this story. They have six versions of this event. Two Sundays ago, we heard the version according to John. Today, we heard the version of this event according to Matthew. Kaya kung titingnan natin yung banal na kasulatan, yung mga ebanghelyo, merong mga pagkakaibhan sa kanilang pagsasalin version sa pangyayari. Halimbawa, merong dalawang pagsalin sa kapanganakan ng ating Panginoong Jesus. Merong apat na pagsalin sa kanyang pagkamatay. Merong anim na pagsalin sa pangyayaring ating napakinggan sa Ebanghelyo ngayon. Yung himala kung saan pinarami ni Jesus, yung limang pirasong tinapay at dalawang isda. Baka dalawang tinapa. So with the six versions that we have of today's event, the evangelists kept telling this story over and over again, and in a very peculiar way. Because we see in the New Testament, it is usual that the way in which Jesus performs his miracles is described. Halimbawa, yung bulag na ibinalik sa Panginoon yung kanyang pagkakakita, ayon sa salin ni San Marcos, anong ginawa ng Panginoon? Dinuraan niya yung mga mata ng bulag at nakakakita muli yung bulag. Sa salin ni San Juan, anong ginawa ng Panginoon? Dinuraan niya muna yung lupa, kinuha niya yon, gumawa siya ng masa, minasa niya, putik, at pagkatapos ay inilagay niya yung putik na iyon doon sa mga mata ng bulag at sinabihan yung bulag, "Sige, maghilamos ka doon sa lawa ng Siloam." Merong mga detalye. Ngunit dito sa ating ebanghelyo, kung saan merong himala na ginawa ng ating Panginoon, hindi tayo sinabihan, hindi isinalaysay paano nangyari yung pagpaparami ng limang pirasong tinapay at dalawang tinapa. Did food fall from the sky like manna? O baka nagmahiwaga ang ating Panginoon? O baka optical illusion lang yon? So instead, all that we have in this story is the beginning and the end. Parang fairy tale. In the beginning, once upon a time, kumbaga, around not only 5,000 individuals, when we count the women and children, there must have been, according to Bible exegetes, 15,000 hungry mouths to feed. Anong ending? Busog sila. Parang sinasabihan tayo. And they ate happily ever after, satisfied with 12 baskets of fragments left over. It is a miracle story without a middle. So what's in the story that lacks plot? This strange miracle story was so important in the early church, to the early church, because it provided them and provides us with a clear definition of faith. Faith is what God can do for you. Faith is not what we can do for God. Faith is what God can do for you. Faith is believing that God knows our troubles. Alam niya yung ating mga hangarin, yung ating mga ligalig, at hindi niya tayo iiwanan. Kaya sa Ebanghelyo, nung nakita ni Jesus yung kakapalan ng mga tao, ano ang nasa isipan niya? Pagkain ay hindi natin pwedeng pauuwiin ito. Walang laman yung tiyan, gabi na nga. Paghanap tayo ng pagkain. He will not abandon us. He will give us provision for the journey. He will feed us. Even though we do not know how, God will do this. Kaya hindi po maipagpalagay ng mga apostol, paano nga ba ito mangyari? Panginoon, meron lang kami dito, 5 pirasong tinapay, 2 isda. Aanhin ito sa hindi lang 5,000, kundi 15,000 katao. This is the first ever fast food service in all of human history. A vast catering service provided by the Lord. What good are 5 loaves and 2 fish for 15,000, not only 5,000 hungry mouths to feed? So faith is believing that God knows our hunger and He will satisfy it, even though we cannot picture how such solution might occur. Kaya kung ating isalin ang pangyayaring ito sa ating buhay ngayon, ganito ang mangyari. When we are worried about a friend, family member who is struggling, probably with some form of anxiety or depression, struggling with drugs probably, faith is believing that God knows that problem and somehow will lead the person we love to a better place, even though we think the situation seems hopeless. Or when we have a relationship with someone that is physically, that is morally, mentally, financially abusive, kung nandoon ka sa isang relasyon na iyon, anong gagawin mo? Ang payo ko, lumabas kayo sa relasyon na iyon. Hindi yon makatutulong sa iyo. Hindi yon ikinabubuti sa iyo. But faith is believing that God sees that rupture and He is working to bring it to a place of some resolution, even though we cannot imagine how that will take place. Or probably when we have to recover from a serious disease, siguro nagkaroon tayo ng meron tayong big C cancer, or probably dahil lumalangoy tayo panahon ng bagyong Karina, nagka leptospirosis tayo. O siguro nagkaroon tayo noon ng COVID-19 at marami tayong mga pangamba. Dahil siguro, nako, mamamatay ako dito, i-intubate ako dito. Faith is believing that God knows our fears and He will give us strength even though it seems impossible to us. tayo po ay nabubuhay sa isang mundo na marami pong mga himala, lalong-lalo na araw-araw. Ating matatamasa yung mga himalang yon sa banal na misa. Let's make sure we take the time to be aware of these miracles in our own lives, because every time we take one in, we recognize the presence of God. Remember, faith is believing what God can do for you. So in the context of today's gospel, in the Lord's Prayer, He teaches us to ask for our daily sustenance. Ano yung baon hinihingi natin sa Panginoon araw-araw? So, we go outside of this church, living our faith, extending our prayer in our work, and praying to God, Lord, You have led us to be fed. Grant us now our daily bread.
Please stand.
Gathered like the crowd in the gospel and hungry for the word of God, we turn now with confidence to our Heavenly Father, who never fails His people in their need. Our reply, You are our bread, O Lord.
You are our bread, O Lord.
That the church throughout the world may bear witness in word and deed to God's love and concern for the hungry and the needy, let us pray to the Lord.
You are our bread, O Lord.
That the world leaders and all who hold positions of great power may help distribute the world's resources in such a way that no country may be in danger of famine, let us pray to the Lord.
You are our bread, O Lord.
That as a community, we may be men and women of prayer, and that we may be prepared to give of our time and talents to help those searching for the meaning of life, let us pray to the Lord.
You are our bread, O Lord.
That the sick and the suffering may experience the sustaining love of God, let us pray to the Lord.
You are our bread, O Lord.
That the faithful departed may enjoy forever the eternal banquet in heaven, let us pray to the Lord.
You are our bread, O Lord.
Heavenly Father, be mindful of us who are in need of Your mercy. Fill our hearts with Your love and never allow us to be separated from You. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Friends, pray that your and my sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to You, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Heavenly Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, His resurrection we confess with living faith, and His coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
We pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accord with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We offer each other the sign of peace. Magandang umaga sa lahat. Magandang buhay.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
The bread of life that came down from heaven is no other than Jesus himself, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Now blessed are those invited to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please stand.
Let us pray. Accompany with constant protection, O Lord, those you renew with these heavenly gifts, and in your never-failing care for them, make them worthy of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. We go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Purihin ang Panginoon.